The sacred island of Okinoshima and associated sites in the Munakata region. Comprised of the religious sites that make up the three shrines of Munakata Taisha, Okitsumiya on Okinoshima, which sits 60 kilometers off the coast of Fukuoka Prefecture, Nakatsumiya on Oshima, and Hetsumiya on mainland Kyushu, it is now a World Heritage Site consisting of the Yohaisho Worship Hall and the tombs of the Munakata clan where they once performed rituals. Japanese culture expert Robert Campbell and I, Lemmy Duncan, traveled to this mystical World Heritage Site revered since ancient times by the people in the Munakata region, and now we'll share it with you. The Mysterious World Heritage in Japan. Episode 3, Munakata Taisha Shrine, Okitsumiya.
We are on our third day.
Yes.
Just about to take off, leave this beautiful little fishing harbor, right, out to the ocean.
Right. And this is the boat we're going to take.
This is our sea taxi. Yeah, it's called the sea taxi. And we're going to ask him to bring us around the island of Okinoshima, which is way out on the ocean on the other side of it.
Oh, it's on the other side.
It's on the other side. It's forbidden. It's a forbidden island. We can't get off the boat and walk around. But we can sail around and take a look and feel the sort of spirit of it. And maybe think about and imagine what's going on there over the centuries as well. So you want to
get on? Yes, let's go.
Maybe in here, right?
Okay.
There are a lot of sort of fishermen out. Let's see. That's been really catching my
We spent about 30 minutes rocking to and fro in this small boat until we finally arrived at a place where we could see Okinoshima.
Do you see that?
Oh, there it is right there.
Yes.
Wow, that's amazing. Wow. That's really far out from the mainland here.
It is.
That's amazing. That's really beautiful. It's a beautiful island though, isn't it?
Mm.
Imagine though, like so people traveling from Japan out to the Korean Peninsula or beyond that to China. There was trade, people going back and forth. Everybody was really, 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 really anxious about whether they'd make it over there and make it safe back. Thinking about that, you can really sort of imagine and understand how people would want a place to worship and to have.
Tourists are not allowed to disembark on Okinoshima, so let's take a look at this mystical island in this specially filmed video. The perimeter of Okinoshima is roughly 4 kilometers. It is surrounded by steep cliffs, and the island's natural environment remains from ancient times. Giant stone monoliths dot the island, and the ancient people pray to them in the belief gods lived within. In ancient times, people used the island as a guide when crossing the ocean, and eventually came to worship the island itself. In the era when Japan was building a country and society incorporating culture and institutions from the Asian continent, a large-scale ritual of worshiping gods to pray for safe sea voyages and successful diplomatic exchanges began on Okinoshima. It took place during the 500 years between the late 4th century and 9th century, and 22 ceremonial sites have been found. As the entire island of Okinoshima is sacred, only Shinto priests are allowed to set foot on it. As a result, the ceremonial sites have been untouched for more than 1,000 years. At the Okitsumiya Shrine nestled between giant boulders, the Saishi ritual of offering prayers to the gods still takes place today.
now we're headed to Shinpokan.
Shinpokan, which means a sort of museum of treasures, of holy treasures.
Holy treasures.
Yeah.
Hello.
Hello there.
Konnichiwa.
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 学芸員の福島です。よろしくお願いいたします。では早速沖ノ島のご神宝をご紹介いたします。どうぞ前にお進みくださいませ。こちらは沖ノ島の国宝のご神宝 のメインのものでございます。純金製の指輪です。
There's some sort of emblem on it.
ご指摘の通り正面にあるお花の文様が特徴です。4枚の花びらお分かりですか？
はい。Yeah, I can see there are four petals, four flower yes, petals there、yes. with a little round thing in the middle of it. How old is this?
こちらは1500年前に作られたものになります。
Around the year 500?
Wow!
That's amazing! That's
amazing! Here, we were able to get an up-close look at the numerous offerings found at the Okinoshima ritual sites.These are all designated national treasures of Japan.
8万点の、ものが残っていたというのは、この島には信仰が深まる中で、禁忌、掟が生まれてきています。で、いつの頃からそういった掟があるのかっていうのは、分かっていないんですが、具体的には島に禊を終えて入っていくといろんなものを見たり聞いたりというのがあると思いますが、そういったものは決して外の人に話してはいけないですとか、あとは島にあるものは草でも石ころでも土でもとにかく持ち出してはいけない、そういったものがあって、奇跡的に今まで遺跡と、当時の奉納品っていうのが残っていて今に蘇っているということになります。
That's so mysterious, isn't it?
You mentioned that there are 80,000 gifts or items found on the island, but I'm wondering how they originally got there.
この島は発掘調査っていうのを行っていますけれども、その時にこの標高80メートルに古代の採取の跡、大規模な採取の跡が見つかっております。23箇所見つかっておりますが、その時の採取、大規模な採取の時の捧げ物というのがその発掘調査で見つかりました8万点の、当時の奉納品になります。
Where do you think those things were madeThat were actually offered there. They were not made on the island. They were made in other parts of Japan, maybe on the Korean Peninsula, China. Where did all of these wonderful things that we're looking at? Where were they actually manufactured?
まだまだ解明の途中ではございますけれども、当時、国内の、一級品ですとか、そういったものはおそらく今の奈良県とか大阪府とか、京都府を主体として、国を作りました大和政権ですねが制作して用意したものだろうと思いますので、おそらく中央のどこかでその周辺でっていうのは密接で研究は進んでいるんじゃないかと思いますけれども、海外のものというのはちょうどここで国家採取が行われていた時期、4世紀後半から9世紀というのは活発に朝鮮半島とか中国の国と海外交渉をしていた時期になりますので、そういった外交の中でですね、獲得したものの、ではないかっていうふうに考えられています。
It's possible that they're sort of marbleized and mixed together, things that were produced nationally, domestically in Japan at the highest levels of government and artisans, all together with things that were maybe were given in tribute or wereobtained from abroad when they came here as well. That's fascinating.
はい、そうですね。はい。で、その国際色豊かなものがあるというのも一つの特徴になります。はい、外交を反映するようなものになりますからですね。
Wow, that was really an experience, huh? How'd you like it?
I mean, Okinoshima is said to be the island where the gods dwell, and I really do feel like this is day three, right? We've seen a lot. We've just been to Shinpokan and seen all the treasures, and I think we're really storing up a lot of good knowledge and history about this amazing island.
That's great. And not just knowledge, but sort of the sensibility of what it might have been like 1500 years ago. I mean, I had this image of the island being really, really misty, and you say it's divine and sacred,
right.
And we know we can't go there. And actually seeing it up close from the boat sort of strengthened that sort of image of it being a sort of secret, you know, sort of island, imagining, somehow I was like imagining pirates,
around the islands
and things like that as well. But then going through the Shinpokan and seeing the actual objects that were offered there as offerings to the gods, you know, praying for sea safety and things like that. Right. And all of these sort of enormous boulders that they found, these beautiful rings and mirrors and all of these weapons and so forth, that's a real, I think, human treasure. Mm. Not just the objects themselves and the history that they bear, but just the fact that over hundreds and hundreds of years, thousands of fishermen must have gone up on the island, used it, going back and forth between the peninsula, the Korean peninsula and Japan. And everyone just sort of respected quietly and left as it was, this treasure.
Be the biggest treasure, the hearts of the people and their respect for the island.
I mean, we talk about sustainability now and how important it is, but this was actually going on like 600, 700, 1,000 years ago. They realized that they had their own spiritual culture and that needed to be sort of sustained.
And next, we get to go to the ancient tombs of the Munakata clan.
Wow, yeah. These chieftains, these people who were actually sort of governing the place that, you know, hundreds and hundreds of years ago.
I'm not sure if I've ever been to a place like that in Japan.
Yeah, they're really, really rare. And it'll give us another, I think, sense at a different level of becoming closer with history itself and feeling it and learning from it. As well. I'm looking forward to it. And I'm really glad that we're able to walk through all this stuff together. Yeah, it's getting really interesting.
It's definitely different when you're actually there, the way you feel about it. You can read about it, but it's very different when you actually stand there and see it firsthand.
Yeah.
Right. Looking forward to next time.
Today we took a chartered boat to get a closer look at Okinoshima. Then viewed the national treasures found on the island at the Shinpokan Museum. Next, we'll visit the mounded tomb group belonging to the ancient Munakata clan. You won't want to miss it!